Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in our series, Fun with AI. This video is a March 2024 update because since we recorded the previous videos playing and having fun with DALL-E, a new model has been released. It's called DALL-E 3, and it really is an improvement from the quality and the potential that the previous image generation models in OpenAI had. So with DALL-E, we can generate much crisper, nice, well-defined, and high-resolution images that we could do with DALL-E 2. So if you are, or if you have been following this playlist, you may have noticed that all the examples that we originally recorded a year ago were using DALL-E 2 for Python, Node, C#, and Grasshopper, and even for this web app. So what I wanted to do in this video is to give you a quick update of some changes that we've done in the source files in the project for this playlist to update the workflows and some of these techniques for the new DALL-E 3. And the only thing that we have pretty much done is update the options that each one of these scripts and each one of these mini apps that we created in the playlist to update the options so that you can use new DALL-E 3 features. So for example, now when we have a new option that is called model that allows you to switch between DALL-E 2 and DALL-E 3. Remember that you may want to do this because DALL-E 2 as of this recording is still much cheaper to use. So if you just want to prototype or tinker around with things, you may want to do it with DALL-E 2 because it's significantly cheaper than DALL-E 3. So there is a new option with DALL-E 3 only, which is the quality to have a standard image or a high definition image. There are much more options when it comes to size. With DALL-E 3, you can create larger images, and then you can also use landscape or portrait orientations for your image. DALL-E 3 also allows you to give it a new style option where you can select from natural or vivid looking images for your image generations. All right, so what we have done is, and I have done this offline in a live recording, I have not recorded all those changes, but what we have done is we have modified all the scripts that we created on the playlist to update this. So I just want to give you like a very quick overview. So for example, in the case of the Python script, we have modified the options that you have in the size, parameter, and we have modified them from being numerical to be a string. So now with the Python API, you can just try to generate your image. This is going to take some time because DALL-E 3 does take some time. It's just more powerful. We have added the capacity to choose between models, between quality and between style. And we just have added those options to the request body of our calls when doing the API. Again, if you don't know what this means, or if you're new to this playlist, just please go ahead to the playlist, to the Python video, a card to that video will be showing up in the corner, and then see what that meant. The response has just finished, and I can show that the image that I just got is this one, which is a large improvement in the quality and the resolution if you are familiar with the previous videos on this series. In the case of Node and JavaScript, we've basically done pretty much the same. We have added new parameters to the command line. So for example, I don't know if you can see how now I'm calling size inputs, the model, I'm selecting vivid and HD for the options. I have added more of those options, and then I have added those options to the request body of the calls. So now when the request is sent to OpenAI, it contains more metadata that allows me to control what kind of information do I get, all right? And then for the web app, I'm going to show you what I just got. So here I just got this image also. Again, a large improvement in the quality of what we can do here. And then if you remember, for Grasshopper, I have basically created, these were the DALL-E 2 options. I have created a new update where I have added more options, model selector, different resolutions, high definition, vivid styles, whatever. But the request file is the exact same thing because literally the only thing you need to do is to modify the JSON file or the body of the JSON object that you sent as part of your POST request. What we did get is this kind of response from the server, which, and I've also added like a small thing so that we can save that result to our system. So this is the image that we just generated with Grasshopper that we could save to a file on our system, right? And then last but not least, if you remember, we also had a small web app that looks something like this, right? So the web app I have also improved by adding a capacity to choose the model, number of images, more options for image resolution, the quality, the style, and you can see that the image that we got for this one, I clicked on the button before, is this that we are generating. Something that I want to remind all of us is that DALL-E uses this new technique to generate better images that is called prompt transformation. What that means is that even if I say an isometric view of a miniature city, blah, 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 whatever, what DALL-E does in order to enhance the way your images are generated is under the hood, without asking you or letting you tweak any of those parameters, what it uses is it uses a language model to take your prompt and enhance it and make it better according to OpenAI's criteria for what better is. And then it uses that transform prompt to generate the image. So if we actually look at the console, we have added a printout of what is the response that we're getting from the server. And you can see that one of the responses that we get is that there is a revised prompt, which is imagine an isometric view of a high detail miniature city with blah, 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 and blah, 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 you know? And I have also modified the alt text to contain this revised prompt. So if I inspect this object, you can see that now the alt text has the prompt, but it also has the revised prompt. With tilt shift effects, do so and so. I mean, you can literally see that my sentence was 10 words and the enhanced one is like something like, I don't know, 30 or 40. So probably OpenAI has done some studies on how to enhance these text prompts to get better results from the model. I don't know. I also think that it's kind of sad that you cannot turn that off, because then you're basically always going to be getting your images filtered by this language model that arbitrarily chooses how to enhance your images. I have read that there are ways to modify your prompt so that you say, I want exactly what I'm saying, do not change it, etc., etc., but you actually have to write that in your prompt. But anyway, so at least you get you get in the response, you get the sentence that has been modified for you. Okay. All right. Beautiful. So I hope that if you're watching this video, it's also because you did watch the other videos on how to make DALL-E based apps for web, for Grasshopper or whatever, and that you had fun doing that. All right. So this video is going to be now at the end of this playlist. And I think I'm also going to make another video where I also go through some updates that have happened recently on ChatGPT. Okay, so that might be the next video in this series. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed this, you may want to like the video, subscribe, say hi, etc., etc. Bye bye, and see you on the next video.